So dear students, in this video we are going to discuss about an important event in the history of India, that is formation of Swaraj Party. Few of the leaders like C.R. Das, Motilal Nehru will leave the Congress fold and they will form this party. So when you come to the background for the formation of this party, in the earlier video we have discussed that non-cooperation movement, which had attained a great momentum throughout India, was abruptly stopped by Gandhi due to a incident at Chauri Chaura on February 5th, 1922. And the decision to withdraw was taken in a INC session on February 12th, 1922. So, this was not liked by many people. Of course, few people supported Gandhi's idea. And few other people opposed this, saying that why the whole India should pay the price for a minor incident at a remotest place. Okay, so you know Gandhi never welcomed the violence. So he thought that Indian people are not yet fit to initiate a non-violent mass movement. So the bone of contention here was few people wanted to end the legislature boycott. So actually, under the provisions of Montagu Chelmsford reforms, our Government of India Act of 1919, Indians were allowed to contest and get elected to the legislatures, which were lawmaking bodies. So through August Declaration of 1917, this demand was conceded to Indians, because we have discussed in the earlier videos the initiation of Home Rule movement. Its aim was self-government, that is, they demanded Indian representation in the administrative institutions. So through Montagu Chelmsford reforms, this was conceded, and a few people said that we shall contest in the election and enter into the councils, and through the constitutional manner we can defeat the government bills which are anti-Indian in a constitutional manner. So they thought that if we enter into the councils, we can raise our voice and we can defeat the bills which are not favorable for the Indians. This was the demand of few section of peoples in the Congress party. They wanted to put an end to the boycott on legislature, and they want to contest the and enter into the councils and solve their grievances in a constitutional manner. The people who don't want to change the programs of non-cooperation movement, they were called as the no changers. So you have to remember which of the following person is a no changer, which of the following person is a pro changer. So the questions will be typical, and you know how tough the UPSC will ask the questions in the examination. The former were called no changers, and they included Rayanthu Prasad, Sardar Vallabhai Patel, C. Rajagopalachari, etc., who were staunch followers of Mahatma Gandhi, and they said that we should abide by the programs of the non-cooperation movement which are supported by the Mahatma Gandhi. And the other people who were called as pro-changers, they wanted to enter into the legislative council and obstruct the British government, and they thought that they can defeat the bills which are unfavorable to the Indians. These included Chittaranjan Das, Motilal Nehru, Srinivas Iyengar, etc. So actually, in 1922, the session was held at Gaya, and this session was presided by Chittaranjan Das. So he moved a proposal to enter into the legislature, that is, to contest in the elections and enter into the elections and get solved their demand through the constitutional manner. So what happened? His proposal was defeated. So taking it as a moral responsibility, he will resign from the presidentship of the Indian National Congress and he will leave the party, and he along with Motilal Nehru will establish Swaraj Party. Okay? It is also called as Swaraj Khilafat Party or Khilafat Swaraj Party, with C.R. Das as the president and Motilal Nehru as secretary. So, other leaders include N.C. Kelkar, Subhash Chandra Bose, etc. Come to the Swaraj Party. So, these are the aims of the Swaraj Party. As soon as this Swaraj Party is formed, many people in both the parties, that is, I mean Swaraj Party and also the Congress Party, or even the pro-changers and no-changers, they wanted to avoid a situation like 1907. What is the importance of 1907? In 1907, Indian National Congress was divided into two. Extremists left the Congress fold under the leadership of Balagangadhar Tilak at Surat. So what happened after Surat split? The national movement in India has weakened. So these pro-changers and no-changers wanted to see that they should not have a condition like 1907, that is Surat split. And even both sides, they respected Mahatma Gandhi. So finally, they thought that Gandhi's leadership is very important for the benefit of the both sides, pro-changers and also no-changers, and it is good for overall Indian national movement. So finally, a settlement was done at a meeting in Delhi in September 1923, and Congress Party will say that this Swaraj Party is not the enemy of the Congress Party. It is a party within the Congress Party, and they said that these Swarajis will be allowed to contest elections as a group within the Congress, and after the elections we shall decide how to go forward, because if they get more seats, their power will increase. If they get very less seats, they cannot do anything. So the future course of action will be decided after the election results are out. So here what happened? There had a reconciliation between the no-changers and pro-changers in the Delhi session. And even the same thing was also attained in 1924 Belgaum session. So you have to remember the 1924 Belgaum session, because it is the only INC session presided by the Mahatma Gandhi. Okay? Only INC session presided by Mahatma Gandhi at Belgaum in 1924. So this you have to remember, how the Swarajis made a cordial agreement with the Congress Party. So that is reconciliation. Why they want to do so? Because both the sides wanted to avoid any situation like the Surat split. What happened aftermath of Surat split? The national movement has weakened. And, So, when you come to the, significance of Swaraj Party, of course, though it was short-lived, they entered into the, legislatures, they were able to make many reforms. Okay? So, even on the demand of Swaraj Party only, a committee was appointed to look after the flaws in the Montagu Chelmsford reforms or Government of India Act. Okay? Act of 1919. And that committee was called as Buddhiman Committee. Okay? Yeah. So when you come to the significance of Swaraj Party, Gandhi and both the pro-changers and the no-changer realized the importance of putting up a united front in order to get reforms from the government. Just now I told you, though Swaraj Party was formed, they were permitted to contest and it is considered as a party within the Congress. And the Swaraj Party won 42 out of 104 seats to the central legislature in 1993. And the party's program was to upset the government. So they wanted to create deadlocks on every issue. Means if the official members forward any bill, I told you earlier, what is official member? These members are nominated by the British government. If they forward any bill which is against the Indians, they used to oppose that. And even they boycotted all official functions in protest of harsh bills. And even they raised their problems in the legislative assemblies. Okay? And when you come to the achievements of this Swaraj Party, so in 1925, Vitalbhai Patel became Speaker of the Central Legislative Assembly. It is based on the Government of India Act of 1919. So it is very, very important. Before independence, who is the first Speaker of the Central Legislative Assembly? That is Vitalbhai Patel. And whenever the government proposed a budget, they opposed that if it is not favorable for Indian. And very important thing is, they were able to defeat the Public Safety Bill in 1928. Of course, in course of time, once again it was passed. Okay. Then they exposed the weakness of the Montagu Chelmsford reforms. Just now I told you, they demanded to inquire to establish a committee to inquire the flaws in the Montagu Chelmsford reforms. They said that that is totally not suitable for the Indian administrative system. And they gave furious speeches in the assembly on self-rule and civil liberties. So they demanded the civil liberties of people, right? Liberty, equality, fraternity, etc. And they demanded the representation for Indians in various political organizations. That is administrative organization, not political. So when you come to the drawbacks of Swaraj Party, so they were confined only in the council, that is assembly. They could not coordinate their struggle inside the assembly with the mass freedom struggle outside. So they were unable to coordinate their struggle in the assembly to the mass struggle outside. And they totally relied on newspapers to carry their work and message in the assembly to the outside world. Of course, there was no other way for them, but still. And some of them could not resist the perks of power. Actually what happened, some people in course of time so defected the Swaraj Party after winning from the Swaraj Party. They stood loyal to the British. So it is one of the drawbacks of the Swaraj Party. And finally, the death of C.R. Das in 1925 further weakened the party. And later there were internal divisions in the Swaraj Party. They were divided into the responsivists and the non-responsivists. Okay, and the responsivists include Madan Mohan Malviya, Lala Lajpat Rai, N.C. Kelkar. So responsivists wanted to cooperate with the government and they wanted to hold offices or take the ministerships, whereas the non-responsivists like Motilal Nehru withdrew from the legislatures in 1919. It is a party which is short-lived. After death of C.R. Das, it has weakened. And even because of internal factions and divisions and lack of clear ideology, and this is with regard to the Swaraj Party.